Hello friends, welcome to lecture series on economic survey. In our last lecture, that is part 1 of economic survey chapter 5, we have revised inflation and inflation indices, that is CPI and WPI. We have seen inflation trend in India and at global level. We have seen that food and beverages group was the largest contributor to inflation. We have also seen that onion, tomatoes and pulses contributed the largest to food inflation. Also, we have seen the reasons for the rise in prices of onions and tomatoes. Let's start with the reasons for pulses inflation, pulses being the major contributor to food inflation. As you can see in this graph, the rate of pulses inflation went from negative zone, that is -20% in 2018 to positive zone, that is +15.4% in 2019. So this reflects a drastic change in the prices of pulses. But another interesting thing is the production of pulses is actually increasing. Here you can see that it has increased from 163.5 million tons in 2015-16 to 231 million tons in 2016-17. So if you see, this is actually an increase of 41% in the production of pulses within 1 year. Sorry. We have seen in the case of onions and tomatoes that there were supply constraints and the supply could not match demand for various reasons and hence the prices raised. But in case of pulses, we can clearly see that production has increased. So then why prices of pulses are rising? Let's look at this. Now, as you can see here, the production of pulses has increased by 41%. In just 1 year. So there will be an abundant supply of pulses in the market, and we have already seen as supply exceeds demand, prices crash. And hence farmers will not realize good prices for their pulses. So now what happens in the next sowing period, this farmer decides to reduce the area under pulses and grow some other crop. So when the produce reaches market, now there is less supply and more demand for pulses. And as we have seen, when demand exceeds supply, there will be a demand pull inflation. And because of scarcity of pulses, the prices will now increase. So this is the reason for rise in prices of pulses. Sorry again. Other reasons are rains in growing states and thereby fall in the area sown for pulses in the growing states. Summing up the reasons for rise in pulses prices, we can say that there were rains in growing states, thereby decrease in the area sown in growing states, and low price realization by Indian farmers because of high production. Now, according to survey, between 2018 and 2019, the CPI inflation for pulses has gone from -20.2% to 15.4%. We have seen this. It is going from negative zone to positive zone. Negative zone to positive zone. What that indicates is that 1 year the prices of pulses are witnessing a steep rise and the other year the prices of pulses are witnessing a steep fall. And we don't want this for any commodity. We always want prices to be in predictable range. So we'll see what can be the reason for this steep fall in the prices of pulses. We have seen that production of pulses has actually increased, and so there will be an abundant supply of pulses in the market. And as we have already seen, as supply exceeds demand, prices will crash, and hence farmers will not realize good prices for their produce. So now what happens, this farmer decides to reduce the area sown under pulses and grow some other crop. Sorry. So when the produce reaches market, now there is less supply and more demand. So there will be scarcity of pulses, and due to this scarcity, prices of pulses will increase. Now when the next kharif cropping season comes, then the farmer will have to make sowing decisions as to what to sow and in how much area to sow. By this time, because of scarcity of pulses, prices will have already shot up. Okay. So what the farmer will think, if I increase the production of pulses now, I will get good price. Okay. Now as farmer decided to boost production of pulses, what will happen in this period? There will be huge supply of pulses and the supply will exceed demand. And as we have seen, what happens when supply exceeds demand? When supply exceeds demand, prices will crash. So this whole cycle where farmers are influenced by last year's prices, and when they base their sowing decisions on the premise that there is pre-existing demand in the market, and hence they will get good return, and this causes the supply to exceed and eventually prices to crash. This whole cycle is not known as Cobweb phenomenon. So this actually happened in 2014 when the prices of pulses in the market skyrocketed. And seeing this, farmer boosted the production of pulses, but eventually in subsequent years, prices of pulses fell. So Cobweb phenomenon is when, after prices of particular agricultural commodity shoots through the roof during a season of scarcity, farmers resort to boosting the production of that commodity. Okay, and that causes the problem of plenty. And then because of this problem of plenty, prices will crash. So this gives rise to a cycle. So what actually happens? Prices fluctuate. Because of that, farmers do not get enough prices. And because of that, they reduce the area sown for that particular crop. That causes lower supply, that causes scarcity, and that causes prices to shoot. But in the next period, what happens? The same farmer boosts its production, and so there is a problem of plenty, huge supply, and prices again crash. So this is a cycle, and this cycle is known as Cobweb phenomenon. So what's wrong with the farmer basing their sowing decisions on the prices they got last year? What's wrong with it? It is wrong because in case of agricultural commodities, supply reacts to prices with a lag of one time period, because supply decisions take time to implement. So that's the problem with agricultural commodities. Okay. So what actually happens in Cobweb phenomenon? We have seen price fluctuations lead to supply fluctuations, and that causes a cycle of rising and falling prices. That's a Cobweb phenomenon. You can see in this graph, price fluctuation caused supply fluctuations. Okay, and that caused a cycle of rising and falling prices. Okay, low supply caused rise in price. Then again, rise in price caused high supply. Then again, high supply caused fall in price. This goes on in a cycle. So this is the cycle. The same cycle you can see in this graph. And the same cycle is reflected in this steep rise and fall in the prices of pulses. Inflation in pulses is represented here, WPI inflation rate for pulses. And the steep peaks on either side of the graph represents Cobweb phenomenon. These peaks on the graph shows that there is a Cobweb phenomenon in case of pulses. The same fact is highlighted in the survey, that the presence of peaks shows the presence of Cobweb phenomenon. Let's take an easy question. The Economic Survey 2019-20 has recently observed Cobweb phenomenon in which of the following case? Rice, wheat, sugar, pulses. If you are watching this video on our website, you can go ahead and click the right answer on your screen. And once you attempt all the questions in this video, you can also get your score. So the answer for that is D, we have seen pulses. Now, is this Cobweb phenomenon good? No, because price fluctuations lead to supply fluctuations and that will cause inflation. And Cobweb phenomenon gets reflected in the prices. Then we have to prevent this Cobweb phenomenon because we want prices of food commodities to be stable and predictable. So when we talk about the measures to prevent, let's revise why the Cobweb phenomenon is actually happening. So it happened basically because of two reasons. Farmers are basing their decisions on last year prices, okay, and they are not getting good prices for their produce. So we want farmers should get good prices for their produce, and we want farmers to be safeguarded from price shocks and crop failure. So what is the solution? Safeguard the farmers from crop failure and price shocks. So government takes measures to prevent the same. Following are the measures that government has taken to prevent farmers from the price shocks and prevent the Cobweb phenomenon. There's a price stabilization fund. There is Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana. Government is providing more warehouses. Government is improving transportation, and there is ENAM. All these measures and even more measures like this help to prevent the Cobweb phenomenon. Now let's see what this correlation coefficient that survey has talked about. Now we know that farmers base their sowing decisions on the prices that they bought in the last period. Okay, we have seen this. So as in this case, if farmers are not getting good prices for their produce in the last period, what he will do in the current period, the farmer will reduce the area sown under the particular crop. Okay, and if he gets good prices, for the produce in the last period, he will increase the area sown for the particular crop, okay, in the current period. That is, he will boost production of the particular crop in the current period. So, as you can see here, there is a direct correlation between the prices of last period and the area sown in the current period. Okay. And is this correlation good? No. Why? Because we have seen that if farmers base their sowing decisions on the prices that they got in the last period, then they will get caught in this Cobweb phenomenon. This is a cycle of rising and falling prices. Price fluctuations lead to supply fluctuations, and that lead to fluctuations in the prices that farmers get for their produce. Okay, so this causes the cycle of rising and falling prices. But we want prices of food crops to be in a predictable range and they should not fluctuate. So higher the correlation coefficient, greater is the possibility of Cobweb phenomenon. Okay, we don't want this to be high. And we don't want this correlation. So correlation coefficient is not good. And by definition, correlation coefficient is the relation between wholesale prices in period T minus 1 and area sown in period T. Wholesale prices in period T minus 1 means last period. And area sown in period T means this is current period. And by correlation coefficient, we will find out whether a correlation exists between the prices and area, whether they are linked, whether a correlation exists between them, between the prices and area sown, prices of last period and area sown in the current period. And if it exists, then how strong that is, how strong the correlation is. Higher the correlation coefficient, higher is the possibility of Cobweb phenomenon. So by knowing the correlation coefficient, we can take preventive measures to avoid the Cobweb phenomenon. So as we have seen the presence of Cobweb phenomenon in case of pulses, survey has listed correlation coefficient for some of the pulses. For gram, it is 0.83. That is a positive correlation. That means there is a possibility of Cobweb phenomenon in case of gram. For tor, it is 0.86. That is an even more strong positive correlation. For urev, it is 0.90. That is even more stronger positive correlation. And for moon, it is 0.6. Here, the correlation coefficient is weak. So there are lesser chances of Cobweb phenomenon in moon. Okay. Now we'll see price volatility. Price volatility means fluctuations in the prices of commodities, and we do not want fluctuations in the prices of food commodities because that has negative effects on both consumers and farmers. Farmers are then more exposed to price shocks, and we do not want that. So we'll see which commodities have the highest price volatility. As you can see in this table, in case of rice, wheat and palm oil, the price volatility is low because there is adequate supply of these commodities, and there is sufficient domestic production as well. And also we maintain a buffer stock for rice and wheat. Okay. Then we come to vegetables. Here the price volatility will be the highest because these are perishable commodities. Also there are supply constraints, like we have in case of tomatoes. In case of tomatoes, there were supply constraints. Maharashtra and Karnataka are the largest producer of tomatoes. So when these areas are under rains, as it happened this time, the supply of tomatoes and rest of the parts of the country were affected, and that's why the prices of tomatoes increased. Okay, then another thing is, there are also incidences of stock holding and speculation, like we see in case of onions. Then in case of tomato, sugar, gram, tor and urad, survey observes that there was a rise in volatility due to supply constraints. As we can see in this graph, tomato, sugar, gram, tor and urad have seen increase in the price volatility. Let's take a question. Which of the following is correct? Higher the correlation coefficient, higher the possibility of Cobweb phenomenon. Higher the correlation coefficient, lower the possibility of Cobweb phenomenon. Only one, only two, both or none. If you are watching this video on our website, you can submit your answer by clicking the right answer on your screens. And you can also view your score for your questions in this video. Hoping that you have submitted your answer by now. The right answer here is A, one only. We have seen that correlation coefficient is not good. Higher the correlation coefficient, higher is the possibility of Cobweb phenomenon. Let's take another question. Which of the following is true? The price volatility of tomatoes has increased because of supply constraints. To reduce the price volatility of onion, government is maintaining a buffer stock for onions under price stabilization fund. Only one, only two, both or none. As you know, if you're watching this video on our website, you can submit your answer by clicking the right answer on your screen. Take some time to answer it. Okay, so answer here is C, both are true. The price volatility of tomatoes has increased because of supply constraints. That's right, we have seen that. And to reduce the price volatility of onion, government is maintaining a buffer stock for onions under the price stabilization fund. So both are true. Moving further, then let's have a look at crude oil and fuel inflation. Survey says that globally, crude oil prices are declining due to weak demand. And in case of fuel, we have seen a rise in inflation. Let's see the trend in global commodity prices. As per the commodity prices published by World Bank, the energy commodity prices are decreasing, food prices are also decreasing, and the metals and minerals index is also showing a price decline. So all the three are declining. Now let's see some measures that government take to control inflation. We know that we do not want fluctuations in food prices, so government tries to stabilize the prices of essential commodities and moderate the prices by following measures. One, government can impose import duty. Like in 2017, government imposed a 30% import duty on chana and masoor because their production was expected to be high in that season. Now, had a cheap imported chana and masoor been available from outside in the Indian market, Indian farmers would also have to sell chana and masoor at lower prices, and thus wouldn't have got a good price for their produce. Therefore, this imposition of import duty on chana saved Indian farmers from price shocks. Next is minimum export price. Minimum export price is the price below which an exporter is not allowed to export the commodity from India. Recently, minimum export price was imposed on onion, and subsequently its export was also banned by government. Why? Because onion prices were continuously rising in domestic market. Now, prices of onion was already high in the Indian market, and in that case, if onions from Indian market are exported to other countries, price of onion will again shoot up. So government imposed this minimum export price on onion along with the export ban. In other cases, government also advises states for effective action against hoarders and black marketers to prevent stock holding and speculation. Also, government sometimes imposes stock limits, that is a restriction on how much of a commodity you can stock at a time. Other measures that government can take is to incentivize farmers to increase their production through various schemes and by giving a minimum support price. Okay. Lately, we have seen a high price volatility in case of onions, and government has taken these measures to reduce this price volatility. Some of the important measures are, there is a buffer stock now of onion, and to bridge the deficit, government supplied onions directly from this buffer stock to markets in Delhi. Government has also imposed a minimum export price on onion, and government also imposed stock limits on onions. So this was all about today's lecture. A very small portion from chapter 5 of Economic Survey Volume 2 is remaining, that is headline and core inflation. This is remaining. Other things we have covered in our lecture today. So we will see in next lecture. Thank you for your patience, and I hope it was helpful. See you in next lecture.